sick. Get over here now. This is no study, boys.
So Prewin Doris's theatre after they invaded. They must be holding Edgar here in their new headquarters. Locked, all right. I'm doing this.
Leech spotted! Watch out, boys!
Die, Bernie!
I cannot enter.
Don't forget to check every door.
Thank you. It's locked. Doris Fletcher was about to become a disaster. I'm getting close to having all the evidence. It's locked, all right.
Better go home, sir. Want some of this?
I cannot enter. It's locked, all right. Blood of a pure heart, garlic, blood of a king. I don't understand. Perhaps this is what McCullum drank. I had better keep that in mind.
Edgar. Edgar, can you hear me?
Jonathan, is it really you?
Easy. Easy. Save your strength. I'm getting you out of here.
Try to spare me. As a physician, I know all too well when it's too late. Punctured lung, broken ribs, and internal bleeding. An accurate diagnosis, wouldn't you say?
Edgar, what happened?
They wanted me to confess. Beat me black and blue.
Jeffrey McCullum ambushed me at the Pembroke Hospital. He was convinced you and I were responsible for the Skull epidemic.
I never imagined that self-righteous fanatic would dare to attack us in the open. What became of him?
To prove him wrong, I let him go.
Really? Are you sure that was the wisest course of action?
Time will tell. The most intriguing part of his accusation was that you and I were the pawns of some ancient vampire.
William Marshall. Yes, they tortured me to make me confess the same nonsense.
I think you're hiding something, Edgar.
What do you mean?
William Marshall, for example. You speak of him as if you know him. How is that?
Jonathan, I cannot say I'm ready for another round of questions.
While investigating the epidemic, I read some of McCullum's findings. I think you have some explaining to do.
I have nothing to hide, Jonathan. Nothing at all.
Doris Fletcher visited her mother at the Pembroke Hospital. That's how she first got infected.
I know nothing about that. Miss Fletcher once came to visit the sick. That is all I know.
No, Edgar, there is more. Doris Fletcher was Harriet Jones's daughter. They exhibited the same symptoms. Blind hate and strong physical mutation.
What does this sad story have to do with us?
Doris and Harriet shared more than a hidden family bond. They were the embodiment of the epidemic and are linked to the Pembroke Hospital. Come on, Edgar, this is no coincidence.
I swear, I'm at a complete loss. All I did was administer vampire blood to cure old Harriet. There was no evil plan, no diabolical plot.
You did what?
I tested the regenerating and healing properties of vampire blood on Harriet Jones. My only intention was to find the cure for influenza, I swear.
Whose blood did you use? William Marshall's? Mine?
Lady Ashbury's. While transfusing her with human blood, humanely appeasing her hunger, I also kept samples of her blood for my research.
You used her blood on Harriet Jones? My God, Edgar, that's unethical. You betrayed two of your patients at the same time.
How dare you judge me? Must I name the alarming list of your victims?
We are both deceivers. But at least I know I'm a monster.
You have worked beside me. You saw what I'm doing at Pembroke Hospital. Jonathan, you know I'm not an evil soul. Just another victim of this tragedy.
Yes, your death is imminent, Dr. Swansea. But I swear, it will be quick.
I already told you to call me Edgar. Am I no longer your friend?
I believe you never have been, sir. You have lied to me at every step and betrayed the trust of a woman I cherish.
You and the lady? Really? Well, I should have seen it coming, I suppose. May I add that I welcome this. The biting, I mean.
You have your wish.
Is it going to hurt? I always wondered if you...
So Harriet Jones became the original carrier when Edgar gave her vampire blood. I must tell Elizabeth.
There's one of them! Watch yourselves!
Ah! What good fortune brings you back to me, Jonathan? What is it, my dear?
I'm afraid it's bad news, Elizabeth. The worst, actually.
Please, speak up.
Edgar is no longer in McCullum's grasp. I resolved that matter.
Where is our good friend now? Is he well?
He was mortally wounded. I put an end to his misery.
That is terrible, Jonathan. And yet you did what you must. The poor man.
Edgar Swansea was responsible for the Skull epidemic, Elizabeth. It was he who unleashed the deadly scourge upon London.
What? Are you certain? This is the most terrible accusation of all.
He confessed everything to me. He sought to cure the disease, to exploit vampire blood to stop the epidemic. But he unwittingly gave birth to a catastrophe.
All those poor victims. How could he do it? What happened?
Edgar gave no heed to ethics. His theory could have been proven to be correct, but he abused the confidence of his patients to test it.
I must say I'm shocked, Jonathan. Who would have thought it? And the poor patient. Let me guess. It was Harriet Jones, was it not?
Yes. That explains how Doris Fletcher was infected, and how she became an Ichor. She secretly visited her mother at Pembroke.
Then we have no choice. We must act quickly, Jonathan. We must return to the sewers and put an end to the threat poor Harriet embodies.
I have one more matter to discuss with you. Harriet Jones was the primary case, but do you know what a healthy carrier is?
There is a tone in your voice that frightens me, Jonathan. What are you trying to say?
It was your blood Edgar used for his experiment on Harriet Jones.
What? No. No. This can't be. Oh.
Elizabeth. Are you all right?
No, I have to go.
What do you mean?
Leave me alone. Save the city, Jonathan. Save what can be saved.
Elizabeth, I need answers. Why did your blood
cause
this?
Stay away from me. Please. I swear I never was your enemy.
Wait. No. Elizabeth. It's locked, all right. Now would be a good time to blend the recipe Marshall used when he fought the disaster. I think I know where to find what I need. Whose blood could be purer than that of William Marshall? Lord Redgrave will have to spare me a drop.
Oh,
still persona non grata in the Ascalon Club. If I want to speak with Lord Redgrave, I'll have to improvise.
Good evening, Lord Redgrave.
What are you doing here, traitor? I shall smite you for this audacity.
I'm not here to bicker, Lord Redgrave. I can put an end to this epidemic, but I need your assistance to do so.
All is already lost. The city verges on collapse. The epidemic has spread so widely. Disgusting skulls are everywhere.
The epidemic could be stemmed if I destroy the original carrier. England can be saved, but only with Marshall's blood.
The blood of William Marshall? Of my maker? Are you mad? This blood is the purest of all. My maker proffered it to me on the battlefield. I cannot hand it to you.
This is more important than the club, you or me. This is London's last hope.
I see. Well, in that case, given the gravity of the situation, I suppose I can spare you a drop.
Thank you, my lord.
If you manage to save this city, you'll prove yourself a veritable servant of the crown. So Godspeed, Dr. Reid. Our fate lies wholly in your hands.